Hi guys, welcome back with me, Ciao 2025. Today we're going to learn about ControlNet and stable diffusion or Automatic1111. ControlNet is a way for you to control your image generation. And there are a lot of ways. One of them is by OpenPose, that you could copy one pose of a picture. You take like the skeleton of it and then put it on another picture, so you don't need to prompt it manually, and you can control how the image gonna be look like, how it's posed and stuff, and how to install it in your stable diffusion. First, you need to access this GitHub as the UI ControlNet by Mikubil. Here is an explanation. You simply need to copy paste the link here and open your stable diffusion. I'm going to put all the links on the description, don't worry. And the stable diffusion, go to extension and install from URL, copy paste this and then click install. I already installed it, so you know it's pretty simple. After you install it, you just need to restart your UI. Check it from the installed here. If there's already exists, then apply and restart UI. If not showing up here, the ControlNet, you need to just close and open it again, the Automatic1111. After that, it's not finished yet. You need to download the models. I recommend Effortless ControlNet version 1.1 here. And simply, there are a lot of options here. It depends on what you want to use, but I mostly use OpenPose here. Maybe you could add Canny and Dap, and you could actually download all, but it's 1.4 gigs. You know, you could experiment it one by one if you want, but in this video, we're going to talk about OpenPose. After you download the OpenPose, then you go to ControlNet that's located in Stable Diffusion Web UI Models ControlNet. This is you put all the download ControlNet. To download the models, simply but click this thing here, the download sign, and you will download the file. I already done that all, so I have the ControlNet and stuff. Now, how we use the ControlNet itself. First, you have to put the image generation here, like usual, the positive, the negative. You select your own models that you want to use. All regular thing until here. Then, you select the ControlNet here. I have three ControlNet. You could setting it here, the start setting, search for ControlNet, and you know you want how many ControlNet that you use, because you could use more than one. In this case, we're going to use one. We're going to use OpenPose here. You need to enable the ControlNet here. You could select OpenPose full or DWOpenPose full. I suggest you select this if you want to copy a pose from a person full body. Then you could select any picture, you know, you take wherever picture, put it in the ControlNet, click here. It's gonna pre-process them. Make sure you click this, sorry, allow preview. This is the pose that you're gonna use for your picture. So yeah, make sure allow preview, but if you don't preview it, it's all right. It's gonna just execute them. But with this, you know what went wrong, because this is how the models or the result gonna be shown. And if this is your first time doing it, clicking the preprocessor gonna download the models. This balance what's more important, your prompt or your ControlNet. I'm going to increase it to 7.68 maybe, the preprocessor. Okay, now we have the ControlNet set up. See sitting down on a sofa. You could add sitting down on sofa, so they generate the picture, generate sofa and stuff, because they don't know if it's sitting on a sofa or what. It's the same position with the picture. And we could actually try another picture here. Example, this picture. Let's pre-process it. Okay. Don't you sitting down on sofa. Actually, if you don't put anything, they're still gonna generate an image. See? Let's see another example. Let's see this hand. You could actually add many picture that you want. I should remove one chain here. Okay, because it's a little to the right. The picture generate not being shown. So we could actually changing the size. Yeah. You could always resize it later and clean this up within painting and repair the face. Maybe use rope and stuff to repair the face. MDPM is the scars for my models because this is really and yeah, the face now look better. Let's add another sample. Here is a very good example. It's kind of confusing if you want a picture looking like this, hands on the, okay, it's not reading the hand on the back of the head, so it's going to have the hand going up, but it's actually able to read it because there's a hand here. Even though there's no hand on this part. I mean, how could you generate this kind of image while using only prompt? That's really confusing. You're not gonna able to create this using only prompt. See, it's pretty good, right? Let's see this kind of pose. Okay, it's not working. The leg should be like this. Maybe we generate once more. Yeah, it's working now. Just, you know, depend on the seat also. I should almost not say for word. Almost should put this like it. Okay, this time we're going to try open pose face. So we're going to focus on the face like this. It's looking up. So let's generate a face that looking up. And a same mouth. Okay, let's try this hard one. I don't think it's going to work, but let's see. Yeah, the mouth is the same. Couldn't read the hand though. Maybe because it's considered the face only. The focus, I don't know, but the mouth is great, man. It's hard to create, you know, like parted lips, open lips. You usually try to do that, right? Let's try this. A little angry face, I guess. Yeah, it's a little angry. Now looking up, it's obviously very easy. What good is, you know, it's not going to detect the hand and stuff, only the face and the head. Try this. Is it going to work? Yeah, it's the right hand though. The left hand. Next, we're going to use open face only. In this case, it only read the face, see? It's not even read the hand. So no matter what the hand do, it only read the face. So you could ask whatever about the hand, you know, it's only care about the head position. Full body, upper body. ControlNet is too strong. Yeah, if we put the face following the face position, since the face position is on this place, you know, so it's going to focus on the face only. In this example, since the face is only up here, it's angry, but you know, the pose not gonna be like this. It only has the face on the front looking in the front, but the position is not looking like this. It's different if you use the W open pose fold. I mean, you should use this if you want to fold. Never use the open pose fold because it detects a lot better than the regular open pose. And this time I'm not pre-render it, but oh yeah, need to back it to the balance and put it in one again. See, the position is the same. Even though I'm not pre-render it, you know, by clicking this is just help you recognize if it's actually read write. Anyway, guys, that's it about OpenPose realizations models. You could use other models, it doesn't matter. Make sure you know what create a good face though. Thank you for watching, and that's it for ControlNet OpenPose. Have a nice day.